Hello and welcome to the Commander's Quarters, your Magic the Gathering source that helps you command your budget. This show and episodes like this one are possible thanks to viewers like you. If you're looking for an easy way to help support this show, make sure that you like, share, and subscribe. Also, hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss any new episodes. You can also go check out our playmats and other merchandise at thecommanderscourters.com. Another easy way to support this show is with our TCG player affiliate links. So whether you're buying a deck or individual cards, you can use this general link right here or one in the description. And the final way that you can support this show is by supporting us directly by becoming a patron. There are many benefits to being a patron, and I truly couldn't do this without all their support. Hey everyone, Mitch coming in from the Commander's Quarters studio. My apologies if I, get a little heated or, misspeak on this episode. I literally just turned the camera on and could be talking about my thoughts on the Rules Committee's decision. If you didn't see it, recently they came out with an, article, on their site or a post on their site that basically said that, the cards from Secret Lair Walking Dead are not banned. First off, I do want to say, please, even if you disagree with this decision, do not badger the Rules Committee members. Do not badger the employees at Wizards. Constructively give them feedback. Okay? All right. Now that we've got that out of the way, I'm going to read some of the kind of important pieces from this article and kind of break it down and give you my feedback on this stuff, basically, and kind of where I stand on it. I want to say first that I'm not surprised with this decision. I was hoping they would have banned the cards, as I believe that it was the right thing to do. I believe that for the Commander community was the right thing to do. I believe that the Commander community was behind that decision. I believe that was made pretty apparent based off of the outcry from the community, from content creators, from essentially anyone except for people at Wizards. Okay, let's get into it. We're not going to bury the lead here. We're not banning the cards from Secret Lair of the Walking Dead. We understand that this won't sit well with some folks. We have spent a lot of the last few days listening to a wide variety of opinions, and we want to thank everyone for taking the time to share their thoughts. It was at times quite overwhelming. It's clear that this is an issue and that many people are passionate about. Again, I do want to thank the Rules Committee for being open to hearing people out on what they had to say. I know that Sheldon was on the Discord quite a bit interacting with the community. So I do want to say that before we go further. Our decision doesn't reflect an endorsement of the cards, but we believe what is best for the commander in the long run. If you like to understand how we arrive at the decision, we encourage you to read on. In my opinion, not banning them is endorsing them. In my opinion, and we'll get to this further, if you have the chance to do something to protect the commander community, and you don't do it, you're endorsing the thing that is going to have a negative impact on the commander community. We identified three major concerns during the course of these discussions, and we'll address each and how they relate to commander below. They are: the availability of these cards is problematic, the existence of non-magic IPs on cards should be discouraged, and Negan is a dubious character. Now, for these three things, I'm probably only going to be talking about the first one because that's really the only one that's relevant when it comes to, in my opinion, something that the most crucial piece of a negative impact on the commander format is that first piece. And I think it's worded in a way, it's not just availability. It's, we'll get to that. Okay. There's no support in the commander philosophy document for banning these cards. They certainly present no mechanical difficulties, and taken simply as cards, don't come to fitting any criteria we have for banning. However, as we are always seeking to improve the document, we discussed whether banning these cards could fit under new philosophical criteria and whether using the balance in this way was appropriate. Yeah, I don't disagree that this is a new precedent. I would like to say that, yes, with new cards and new ways that things are coming out, things need to be adjusted if needed, which in my opinion, it was needed in this case. Card availability. A concern to many players that these cards would not be widely available and for some countries only available through third-party sellers. They worry that this model will be repeated in the future. We've heard you loud and clear on this issue. Because the cards are mechanically unique, this is the major problem most folks have. We wish that all of our friends around the globe had access to these cards. However, the RC of its own accord can't solve this problem. What we can do, what we already have done, is add our voice to yours. Since the issue broke, we've been in contact with well-placed people at Wizards of the Coast to make sure that they understand your displeasure when it comes, where it comes from, as well as urging that they work towards a solution. So, one thing that is said in there is, yes, location is an issue. I'm glad they brought that up. One thing that they didn't bring up in there is the limited availability. At least I don't believe that they did. And how that is a predatory tactic. And saying that Wizards is going to work on something really hasn't worked well in the past for many things. So I don't have too much hopes on them improving this in the future. While we understand why people are concerned about such limited availability, we don't believe that the problem applies to Commander in the same way it does to tournament formats. Successful tournament formats require generally equal and complete access to cards. But one of the themes that we've reiterated since the earliest days of the format is that you don't need access to every card in order to have fun playing Commander. I'm just going to stop right there real quick because I do have something I want to say about that specifically. I think I, potentially out of many people, there's plenty of other budget players out there, the budget channel, I definitely understand the concept that everyone doesn't need access to every card to have fun playing Commander. In fact, like, that's what this channel is about, basically. You know, building decks on a budget for fun. I understand that. That's not the point. That's not the point. The focus of Commander being on non-tournament play, plus the enormous card pool available where almost everything goes, means that unique cards floating around don't present the same kind of problem. The stakes in a Commander game is the fun of the participants, and that doesn't require all the cards. Again, it's not the point. The point is that this is a predatory tactic focused on Commander players, targeted at Commander players to get the most money out of Commander players that they can. A problem we see with adopting a ban philosophy based on card availability is explaining it down the road. If a year from now, someone stumbles across a copy of one of the cards, tries to use it, and discovers that it's banned in Commander, they'll ask why. And that explanation is unsatisfactory. People don't like how they were allocated. This does not make a lot of sense to the person who is holding the card and who doesn't own many other cards that may be out of reach for them. We want people to be able to play the cards they own and only resort to bans when it's problematic for the health of the format, not the wider ecosystem. So let's go through the scenario really quick, okay? If a year from now, someone stumbles across a copy of one of these cards, tries to use it, and discovers that it's banned in Commander, they'll ask why. That's true for any card that's banned in Commander. Literally, okay, I stumble across, I'm a new player, I stumble across Iona. All right, I get that card. I go to a store, I build a deck around Iona, and I try to play Iona, and I am told that it is banned. What's the difference? The difference is that you're not going to stumble across these cards. These cards are going to be expensive because there is a limited print run, and they're mechanically unique. You're not going to stumble across one of these. To me, having an explanation on your site as to why certain cards are banned is probably a good thing. So explaining that these cards are banned not because they are overpowered, but because it was a predatory tactic from a company. Yeah, again, I don't see the issue. I don't see the difference between these two circumstances. If someone builds an Iona deck, goes to a shop, tries to play, someone builds a Negan deck and goes to a shop, tries to play, and both are banned, what's the difference? If they go on your site and they look up and they see, oh, these cards are banned ahead of time, you can have an explanation as to why. In fact, I think you should have an explanation for most of your cards as to why they're banned. I would appreciate that. And many people in the community would as well. Anyways, these cards are in no way a threat to the health of Commander. In fact, we see it just the opposite. We're the only format that could bear the weight of this kind of experimentation. This is the format which Crab Tribal is just as viable as Blood Pod. Adding a few quirky cards that aren't ubiquitously available doesn't threaten that. Again, I think this is deflecting the actual issue. I think that the phrase, we're the only format that could bear the weight of this kind of experimentation, is very ironic because, yeah, we're the only format that they would actually target with this kind of experimentation because this is where most of the money is when it comes to paper Magic now. Standard's dead, or it's on Arena. Other formats are dead or losing popularity. Commander's still popular. People enjoy Commander. This is the only place this experiment could happen. Only place. One of the calls from the community was that we should ban these cards to send a signal to Wizards of the Coast for a blatantly commercial act. First of all, we don't think it's appropriate to tell them how to run their business. That's way outside of the scope of our character. Second, the ban list isn't the appropriate vehicle to voice our displeasure over something, nor is using it as punishment. There's a difference between punishing wizards and protecting your community. Who's in charge of this format rules committee? Is it you or is it wizards? If it's you, protect your community. The ban list is an abstract construct to corporate decision makers. Yeah, right. The right path to walk is the one we've gone down. Real change happens from real conversations with real people, which we have been doing since the news broke. Finally, attempting to send such a signal would be doomed to failure. I don't disagree with that. There are many people speculating that the rules committee, if they made a certain decision, if they decide to ban the cards, wizards would react negatively towards them. Whether that's attempting to take over, you know, basically kind of the rule set of commander and kind of just kicking the rules committee out or whatnot. Not saying that that would happen. The rules committee was in a no-win situation, yes. I don't think that the actual concerns of the community were addressed in this document, and let's just finish the rest of this one. It will not have the effect that people hope. The primary goal of these cards is almost certainly new player acquisition. Wizards hopes to lure some Walking Dead fans into Magic, and any interest from Commander players is just a small bonus. I think out of everything that is said in this entire article, I think that is the one, two sentences, I guess, right there that I have the most problem with. The primary goal of these cards is almost certainly new player acquisition. Sure. Wizards hopes to lure some Walking Dead fans into Magic, and any interest from Commander players is just a small bonus. If that's the case, these cards would have been silver bordered. Literally. That is the only reason. Why were the My Little Pony and Transformers one silver bordered? Why were the Godzilla cards just different prints of an actual Magic card? What's the difference here? Is that new player acquisition is not enough for them. It's a predatory tactic that is aimed and targeted at Commander players. I think most of this article is deflecting. Most of this article is not actually addressing the real problem. I do understand the Rules Committee is in an incredibly difficult position. It's completely unfair of me to ask them to ban them. I just wish they had. Banning the cards until if functional reprints are available doesn't do much either. I highly disagree with that sentence. If you ban these cards until functional reprints are available, it forces wizards to reprint them at some time if they want Commander players playing with them. If you ban them now, sales will go down. Commander players will not buy that. Because they're banned. Wizards can print whatever they want when it comes to Magic cards. I 100% agree with that. 100%. They can do whatever they want when it comes to printing them. That's fine. But Rules Committee, you're in charge of Commander, not them. So when they print something that is problematic to Commander, not just because of mechanically it's problematic, not because it's an overpowered card, but because the tactic that Wizards of the Coast is using to take advantage of Commander players, it is your job to protect them. Regardless if you're in a tough position or not. In conclusion, the community outcry over these cards did not go unheard. It seems to have for me. We use our relationship with people inside Wizards of the Coast to have an honest conversation about how and why so many of you felt betrayed by this process. One of the outcomes of that conversation is that they were supportive of whatever decision we made. We believe the conversation has had influence and they clearly understand the concerns. Thank you to everyone who has weighed in with their thoughts. We tried very hard to keep up with all of them. Even Discord became overwhelming. I definitely believe that. Again, I appreciate the Rules Committee being open to hearing feedback from people, being on Discord, listening to people. But when it comes to whatever that straw poll ended up at, 95% of invested Commander players saying that they want it banned. That they want it banned because they think it's bad for the format that you care about. I highly doubt the Discord was much different than that. If you had that honest conversation with Wizards and let them know why we feel so betrayed by the process, and you didn't bring up the predatory tactics, if you didn't bring up the fact that Commander players don't want this, And if it's not going to stop Wizards from doing this in the future, which they said they're going to in their stream last night, then what's the point? What was the point of you listening? What was the point of you talking to them? What's the point of you being in charge of Commander? Legitimately, what is the point of you being in charge of Commander, a community-driven format that is outside of Wizards, when you're just going to bow to Wizards' decisions? You had a tough decision. In my opinion, you made the wrong one. I understand that there are more important things in this world than Magic. I understand there's a lot going on. I understand it's really dumb to argue about cardboard. I understand that it's dumb to argue about cardboard multiple times in the same week. But there's a lot of people that care a lot about this game and have for a very long time. Started playing back in 2002. And I cared about Wizards of the Coast. I cared. I thought they had what's best in mind for the Commander community, for the Magic community. Commander did not exist back then, well, really in a big way. And of course, like many Magic players, you leave, you come back, right? Last time I came back was because of Commander. Really into it, enjoyed it. Believed that the Rules Committee was making the right decisions for people. Even when I disagree, I disagreed with Paradox Engine being banned, I disagree with Iona being banned, I still believe that the Rules Committee had best intentions at heart. With this decision, I don't believe that anymore. I feel betrayed by Wizards. I feel betrayed by the Rules Committee. And it hurts. You're the only ones that could have done anything about this in any kind of a real way. And you failed. That's far too harsh. I know. That's just how I feel. Again, I'd like to reiterate to everyone, please, please be civil on Twitter, on Reddit, on everywhere. Constructive criticism, please. I never wanted to see the day where Wizards can just control Commander, and I think that day is today. If you didn't have the power to make this decision, did you ever really have any power at all? That's all I've got. Comment below with your thoughts, please. I appreciate hearing from you, community. I'm sorry for emotions getting high in this episode. I'm sorry for misspeaking. I'm sure I did multiple times. And for those of you that are saying that I'm just whining for this week, if you don't believe that I actually care this much about this game, then you can stop watching. You can unsubscribe. I don't care. Okay? Do something instructive with your time. Love each other. And get out there and vote. Voting's important. Okay. Thanks, everyone. Have a good one.